Hello everyone! Today we shall speak about heat capacity and the magnetic susceptibility of the Ising ferromagnet in the mean field approximation. We shall obtain their temperature dependencies and analyze some features that occur at Curie point. Also, we shall introduce the critical exponents that describe the behavior of some physical quantities near the critical temperature of phase transition.
By definition, the heat capacity of ferromagnet is the derivative of internal energy with respect to temperature. At zero magnetic field, we have the following expression. Therefore, the expression for heat capacity takes the following form, where C0 is the contribution to heat capacity which is not associated with magnetic ordering, and Cs is the spin magnetic component. At T is greater than theta, the order parameter is equal to zero. Therefore, Cs is equal to zero at any temperature, and total C of T is equal to C0. At T is less than theta, the order parameter has the following form. So, the x squared looks like this. In this case, we can find the expression for Cs. Abrupt jump of heat capacity at Curie point is concerned with the appearance new degrees of freedom in the system. So, at T is greater than theta, we have 0 mu iz for any I, and at T is less than theta, we have non-zero mu iz for any I. The non-zero mean magnetic moments of all atoms are appeared. Every degree of freedom has associated with it, on an average, energy of 1/2 Boltzmann constant T. At T tends to zero, the order parameter has the following form, thus we know x squared. In this case, the expression of Cs has the following form. Therefore, Cs of T exponentially tends to zero at T tends to zero. Generally speaking, C0 is not equal to zero, thus total heat capacity takes the form as it is shown on the picture. E' at Curie point, the abrupt jump takes place. Note that for the heat capacity, the mean field approximation gives qualitatively wrong result. As we can see, mean field approximation predicts the abrupt jump for heat capacity, but in fact, it has divergence, as it is shown on the picture. Such characteristic feature of the Ising ferromagnet heat capacity is called lambda point. Now, let us speak about magnetic susceptibility. First of all, recall its definition. In paramagnetic state, the magnetization is equal to zero at zero magnetic field, and magnetization is not equal to zero only at non-zero field. In this case, conventional magnetic susceptibility coincides with the differential one. Earlier we showed that at T is much greater than Curie temperature, magnetic susceptibility could be described by Curie-Weiss law. Let us find the expression for differential magnetic susceptibility in all temperature range from 0 to infinity. What should we do? We must obtain the M of H dependence and differentiate it with respect to H. We already know the expression for magnetization. Thus, we should find the dependence x of h. It can be found from the Curie-Weiss equation with regard to magnetic field. Since in this equation we have so-called the field in units of energy rather than traditional magnetic field, let us make the following conversion. Considering that we don't know the dependence x of h, let us differentiate the both sides of the Curie-Weiss equation. Here we take into account the derivative of the hyperbolic tangent. Maybe this differentiation will be difficult to you, therefore I recommend to perform these mathematical manipulations once again independently. Therefore, the expression for chi of t takes the following form. Further, we should tend the magnetic field to zero, i.e. take as order parameter the solution of the Curie-Weiss equation without magnetic field. We already know this solution, and in limiting cases, at temperature tends to zero, and at temperature is less than theta, and temperature tends to the Curie point from the left. Let us analyze the chi of T dependence. At T is greater than theta, the order parameter is equal to zero, so the chi of T has the following form. Thus, we obtain the Curie-Weiss law. Therefore, the Curie-Weiss law is correct in the temperature range from theta to infinity. In test, the magnetic susceptibility is diverged at temperature tends to theta from the right. So, the magnetization itself is finite, but its rate of change becomes infinite at field tends to zero and at temperature tends to theta. At T tends to theta from the left, we know the expression for the order parameter as well. In such case, the expression for magnetic susceptibility will be the following. So, at T tends to theta from the left, magnetic susceptibility is also diverged, and the character of divergence is the same that at T tends to theta from the right. Let us unify these results. Finally, at T tends to zero, the order parameter has the following form. In this case, the expression for magnetic susceptibility looks like this. Thus, the magnetic susceptibility exponentially tends to zero at T tends to zero. The resulting temperature dependence of chi is shown on the picture. So, why is the magnetic susceptibility tend to zero at T tends to zero and at T tends to infinity? The reason is that in both cases there is nothing to ordering. At T tends to zero, all the magnetic moments are already ordered, even without a magnetic field. And at T tends to infinity, atoms do not have the mean magnetic moments. Let us introduce the critical exponents. What is it? We obtained that at temperature tends to Curie point, the magnetic susceptibility diverged by the following law, and order parameter has the square root singularity at the temperature tends to Curie point from the left. As for heat capacity, in the mean field approximation, it has the abrupt jump. Critical exponents alpha, beta, and gamma are denoted as follows. In the case of ferromagnetic phase transition, in the mean field approximation, we have alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to 1/2, and gamma is equal to 1. Let us compare these results with the numerical calculations, three-dimensional Ising model, and experimental data. Overall, there are about 10 different critical exponents, but some of them depend on each other. It can be exactly shown that alpha plus 2 beta plus gamma is equal to 2. In the mean field approximation, the expression mentioned above is also correct, but unfortunately, each exponent separately is incorrect. It is believed that critical exponents have universal character. In other words, they do not depend on the physical nature of the substance. Well, let us summarize the results obtained above. We found that temperature dependencies of heat capacity and magnetic susceptibility of the Ising ferromagnet in the mean field approximation possessed some characteristic features. As we can see, mean field approximation predicts the abrupt jump for heat capacity, but in fact it has divergence. As for magnetic susceptibility, its temperature dependence diverges at Curie point, and the character of this divergence is the same at temperatures tend to the Curie point from the left and from the right. Also, we introduced the critical exponents that described the characteristic behavior of physical quantities, such as order parameter, heat capacity, and magnetic susceptibility, near the phase transition temperature, or in our case, near the Curie point. There are about 10 different critical exponents, but some of them depend on each other. Unfortunately, mean field approximation have rather bad agreement with the experiment, more often quantitatively and sometimes qualitatively. Nevertheless, the expression relating some critical exponents with each other is quite correct in the mean field approximation.